Hello and welcome to SciJoy. Today we're going to be talking about Google's Make It in Science Journal app and how it records real-time sensor data. With a science journal, no code is required. You can just open the app and observe the values obtained from the sound, acceleration, and light sensors already on your device or from an external sensor. If you want to do more than just watch real-time data, you can create projects. And inside these projects, you can have sets of experiments, and each experiment can contain several trials. Let's start with quickly observing incoming values. The eye icon always takes you to the real-time data and can be accessed through the menu. This block right here is called a card. The microphone detects the different sound levels and it measures the intensity in dB or decibels. To get a better understanding of what the sensor is doing and what the numbers are, you can click on the Learn More link. This shows you a range of decibels and associates them with known sounds. Going back to the card, we can toggle between the numbers or seeing a live graph of the data being plotted. You can listen to the data by enabling the audio. You can set the sound to scales or to notes, and this is great for accessibility, but I wouldn't show this feature to an entire classroom. I've made this mistake before when teaching robotics programming. You can toggle to additional sensors on this bar, or you can just add a new sensor by hitting the plus button and a new card will appear. Our device reads acceleration in the X, Y, and Z directions. The information view not only shows you the number for the acceleration, but also the direction in which it's acting. The X and Y are the directions that we can move the device when it's sitting on the table. And when they're at rest, they're close to zero. Z is the acceleration felt through the phone, and it hovers around 9.8 meters per second squared. This is the measurement of the gravitational acceleration that the device feels. Other devices may also have a light sensor card that you can add. Using the sensors that we already have on our device, what questions can we answer? Could we explore our dog's bark with the sound sensor and see if there's a variation in timing or intensity for different types of barks? Could we also use it for sleep tracking? Could we listen to movement while we roll around or snore while we're resting? What would a graph look like if we're walking compared to running or climbing upstairs? Let's try a step tracking project. If we go to the menu bar, we can go to the project. It needs a title, a photo, and a description. The photo has to come from your gallery of existing images, and it will be used as the banner for your project. You don't have options to crop, but it pretty much just takes the center of your photo. You can have several experiments within one project. We can test walking, running, and climbing stairs. The blue plus button will allow you to create experiments within your project. It needs a title and description. These will be listed in the order that they have been run. You can add experiment notes. This could be a picture of your setup or a description of it, and the picture doesn't have to be one that already exists in your gallery. The picture that you take will become your experiment's icon, and it will save into the gallery on your phone so you can use it later if you have to write a lab report. Inside your experiment, you can create trial runs by clicking on the observation button. You can go back to the experiment by clicking on the beaker. You can select the different sensors that we want to use. And when it's all set up, we can press the record button at the bottom and run our trial. The timeline at the bottom starts to scroll in the opposite direction and time continues to increase. You're able to add notes during the trial if something interesting happens, and it will be timestamped to the moment that you press the note button. And you can add pictures to your notes too. When you're done, you just press stop. The trial can be played back and you can scroll through the sensor data. You can scrub through and add more notes. These notes will be on each of the graphs for the sensors. You can export the data to different apps on your device, but one of the best locations that you can export it to is Google Sheets. You have to export each sensor separately, and I suggest noting which sensor that you're exporting in the title of your file. The time is in Unix time, and a conversion equation is given in the description below. When you add a trial to your experiment, it selects the same sensors as the previous one. You can scroll through the completed trials side by side. The app is able to communicate with some Bluetooth devices, including the Arduino 101, Blend, and the Arduino Mega 2560. We set up our Arduino 101 using the firmware and walkthrough guide provided by the Making in Science GitHub. Once the firmware was uploaded, we found the device by clicking on the microchip icon. Raw is a percentage of the voltage input and it goes from 0 to 100. Custom seems to be determined by your analog to digital converter, because ours seems to go from 0 to 1023. You can only record one input at a time, but you can switch between the pins that you are monitoring. This is an excellent way to do some real-time troubleshooting or to record a single sensor. Thank you for watching this episode of SciJoy. We're going to be working with the Making in Science team in the future, and we wanted you to be able to use the application. So if you have any questions for us, you can leave them in the comments below or on any of the social media platforms. And if you have specific questions for the Making in Science team, I put a link to their form down in the description. You can support us at patreon.com/SciJoy, and remember, keep exploring.